Hi there, I'm Kat, and today I'm going to show you how to create a simple scatter brush in Adobe Illustrator to add falling snow to this winter forest background. Making a basic scatter brush is super easy. The brush we're making today is actually just going to start with this one simple shape you see on the left, and it's going to turn into this magic snow scatter brush we have on the right. The document size we'll be working with today is 1920 by 1080. I'm going to be using this winter woods illustration I've been working on as my background. If you'd like to follow along, I've linked a free starter file in the description below, so you can open that up, or you can make a new document with these dimensions and just use any solid background color that will allow the white snowflakes to show up as you're working. To get started, I'm going to just move my artboard over here. We're going to work right off to the side. I'm going to grab my ellipse tool. You can find it here under the rectangle, or L on your keyboard is the shortcut. And I'm going to go to my swatches panel and just make sure that my fill color is set to white and my outline color is set to none. Okay, to make my ellipse, I'm going to click once with the ellipse tool selected. I'm going to get this pop-up, and we're going to set the initial ellipse to 8 pixels by 8 pixels. We're going to zoom in a bit so we can see this better as we work with it. Now I'm going to grab my direct select tool by pressing A on my keyboard, and we're going to just alter this snow shape a little bit so that it looks more organic when we create our brush. The goal here is just to make it not quite a perfect circle, and you'll see how this works when we start applying things like rotation to our scatter brush. I think that's fine for now, and we're ready to go ahead and create our first brush. I'm going to zoom out here so we can see what we're working with, and I'm going to grab my selection tool, which is V on your keyboard, and I'm going to select just my snow shape here, making sure nothing else is selected. Now I'm going to open my brushes panel, and you should be able to find this under the window menu if it's not there, and we're just going to click this plus sign at the bottom to add a new brush. The new brush dialog will pop up, and we're going to pick scatter brush and hit OK. I'm going to name this brush snow. You can name it whatever you like, and before we do anything with the settings, we're just going to hit OK here. Okay, I'm just going to move my art over here a little bit more. I'm going to grab the pen tool now. I'm going to click once at the top of the artboard and once at the bottom of the artboard, and just hit escape to get out of that line. And you should see your brush already applied to this line. If you don't, go ahead and go to your brushes panel and make sure that the new snow brush is selected. Once we have our sample stroke done, make sure that's still selected. Go into your brushes panel and just double click on your snow brush to bring up the scatter brush options. You'll see the first option here is size. We're going to start here and change this to random. And as you can see, you can actually watch in real time the changes that you're making to your brush as you drag these sliders. This is the benefit of creating the brush and a sample brush stroke before you go and start playing with options. The size parameter is fairly simple. The left slider here will control the minimum scale of your shape, and the right slider controls the maximum scale, and this is based on your original artwork. For this brush, I'm going to go ahead and set the minimum to 10% because I want the flakes to start fairly small, and I want the maximum scale to be almost double the size of our original art because I think that gives us a nice variation in size. Next parameter is spacing. We're going to go ahead and set that to random as well. And this just controls the spacing between instances of your original artwork. If you go ahead and start playing with these sliders, you can see how that works. I'm going to make this as random as I can possibly get it by moving my left slider to the leftmost setting, which is 10%, and my right slider to 1000%, which is the maximum. And this gives us the most variation in spacing that we can have. I think that looks pretty natural for snow, so I'm gonna go with that. Now we'll move down to the scatter property, which is really where the magic happens for this kind of brush. And of course, we're gonna put that to random as well. Now, the left slider here will control the random distance of your particles to the left side of your line, and the right slider will do it for just on the right side of the line. So if for some reason you want a brush where all the particles fall to one side of where you're drawing, you can do that. For this brush, again, I'm going to set this as random as I can possibly get it by going all the way to the left on the left slider to minus 1000 and all the way to the right at 1000% for the right scatter. Now you can see that it's definitely starting to look like snow. Okay, and for the last parameter here, we're going to set rotation to random. This will be really subtle on this brush because we started with an almost perfect circle, but we will get a little bit of variation here. So again, I'm going to set these sliders to the max range so we can get as much rotation as possible. And of course, if you're doing a different type of brush, like maybe you start with a star shape, you'll see this a lot more apparently. But for our brush, it's just going to add that touch of organicness. For this brush, I'm not going to worry about colorization, but if you do want to check out the options here, they have this little hint window, and I would use hue shift if you do want this brush to be a color changing brush where it will change with your stroke, so you can go ahead and do that if you like. I'm going to leave mine set to none, and we're going to click OK. After you click OK, you'll see this dialog pop up, and this is going to ask you if you want to apply these changes to the strokes that already have this brush applied. We are going to click that. And now you'll see your preview of your final brush, and you're ready to start using it. I would normally recommend keeping your base shapes so that you can make variations of your brushes quickly and easily. For this demo, I'm gonna go ahead and delete the base shape and our sample brush stroke, and I'm going to move over to our background layer here. Now under our layers panel, I'm going to use the blank snow layer to start drawing in my snow with the brush tool. If you are using your own file, just make sure that your backdrop is locked and that you're drawing your snow on a new layer. Now I'm going to change to my brush tool by hitting B on my keyboard, and I'm going to start drawing a loose zigzag over my background just like this. You don't have to worry about covering everything on this first pass because we're going to add. Now, that gives you your first layer of snow, and I think it looks pretty good. We've got a good scatter going. It looks kind of natural. You can see some variation in the size and rotation. And now you just want to add to this where you think there should be more snow. I'm going to add some more at the top here, and I think that looks pretty good to me. Now, one trick I want to show you is that if you grab any of your brush strokes, and say you like the placement, you want snow there, but you don't quite like how the randomness turned out. If you have that brush stroke selected and click on your brush again, this is gonna go ahead and re-randomize every time you click on it. So that's just a fun note if you wanna give that a try. You can also edit your paths with the brushes applied if you wanna move, say, some of the snow up here and use it to kind of fill out empty areas as you see fit. Another quick way to add variation to this is to vary some of the brush strokes' opacity and size. For this one, I'm just going to add this zigzag line and go ahead and select that. And opening my transparency panel, I'm just going to see what looks good here. I'm going to set that to around half transparency. And another thing you can do is add, maybe I want some larger snowflakes here, so I'm going to set this to 2 points on my brush stroke. Let's see, we'll go back and add some of that. And just a note here, because you set your transparency, it's gonna stay at your last setting. So now I'm gonna turn this back up to 100%. Just add a few here and there. Also, you can just dot with your brush and you'll get a random snowflake. Sometimes they're so small you can't see them. Sometimes you'll get some big ones. So that gives you a little bit more control. And I'm just gonna add just a couple more these large flakes with random opacity. And there we go. I think that looks pretty fun. You can certainly play around with different line weights, different opacities. You could even change the color. Maybe you want some of your strokes to have a light blue tint just to give it a little more variation. You can really kind of go crazy with this. Just as a last cleanup step here, I'm going to show you how to trim the snow around the artboard if you'd like to. Go to your layers panel, make sure you're on your snow layer where we brushed all of our snow, and just use this selection column to click and select all of the snow. I'm going to go ahead and hit Control G to group that, or Command G on a Mac. And I'm going to grab my rectangular tool here and just draw a frame that should match the artboard. Go ahead and check in your properties panel that it's exactly 1920 by 1080. And we'll go ahead and use our shortcut keys right here just to make sure it's centered on the artboard, both vertically and horizontally. And we're gonna use that shape for our clipping mask. So just go ahead and go back to your snow layer. Make sure that the rectangle is on top of your snow group. And again, we're going to click in the selection column just to select everything on that layer. And I'm going to hit Control 7. You can also find clipping masks under Object. Scroll down here to Clipping Mask and Make. And there you go. Now your snow is trimmed to your artboard, and you'd be good to go to export this image and use it for your designs. I hope this video was helpful. If it was, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe if you'd like more tutorials like this.